Good afternoon. Welcome back to the Basin Reserve in Wellington. A slight wind has picked up since we were last here, but otherwise, still a brilliantly fine day. The teams have made their way onto the pitch, the official introductions to be made, and then the kick-off. Time to look at the two teams for today's cup final. Firstly, Christchurch United, starting with goalkeeper Alan Stroud, 2, Lawrence Fitzpatrick, 3, Kevin Calder, 4, Michael Boomer, 6, Mike Fullen, 7, Michael McGarry, 8, Danny Halligan, 9, Alan Carville, 10, Keith Braithwaite, the captain, 11, Julian Falloon, and 14, Johan Verwey. And the Mount Wellington lineup for today's match. In goal, we have number 1, Grant Schofield, 3, Ronnie Armstrong, the veteran, 4, Marty Jennison, 5, Andy Brown, 6, Michael Redenton, 8, John Lay, 9, Grant Lightbound, 10, Noel Barclay, the captain, 11, Eddie Gavigan, 14, Steve O'Donoghue, and 15, Dave Woodaveen. So the scene is set here at the Basin Reserve in Wellington. Less than 5 minutes to kick off. We'll be back after the break. The national anthem here this afternoon from the group When the Cat's Been Spayed. Just 3 minutes to kick off. Time to join our commentators, John Adshead and Ricky Herbert.
Thank you very much indeed, Stephen, and welcome everybody to the Basin Reserve and the entertainment that we've had in the past hour from When the Cats Are Spayed. We can hope that entertainment etches forward now into what should be a magnificent game of football between Braun, Mount Wellington and 3ZB Christchurch. Tremendous afternoon here today, and with me in the commentary box is former All-White captain Ricky Herbert. Ricky, a tremendous setting for today's game.
Exactly, John. It's tremendous. The weather's perfect, the pitch is very, very playable, and the two sides, I'm sure, are going to produce some very fine football.
Well, disappointment as always in cup finals. Terry Torren's been taken sick this week, and Johnny Lay will take his place in the Mount Wellington lineup, and Christchurch United will be at full strength. Both players just having the final warm-up. There's Kevin Calder, a long-time stalwart of this Christchurch side, number 3. And, of course, exciting days for both coaches today, Mr. Martin Stewart. And, of course, David Taylor. David Taylor and Martin Stewart in the first seasons with National League clubs and both tremendously proud records to be in a Cheltenham Cup final in their first seasons. Another aspect of today, both teams wearing brand new Adidas strips, the European strips made by Adidas. Both teams looking very, very smart indeed. Michael Redenton in pitcher. Had a marvellous season both for Braun Mount Wellington and of course for the All Whites. The setting is set. This tremendous game. It's amazing. These two teams have been in finals for 15 times between the two of them, and yet they didn't meet. And the last time they met was 1972. Ronnie Armstrong there, the veteran of the side. Ronnie Armstrong played in that game in 1972 and scored 2 goals in that final, which was a marathon. Went to 2 replays before Christchurch finally edged out the mound at Newmarket Park by 2-1. And the history of that game was a very disappointing one for David Taylor, the Mount Wellington coach, when he scored in the 87th minute back in 1982. Only time his goal disallowed, and Christchurch won the game. Well, teams beginning now to settle down. It's a very nervous time for players. A lot of these players very experienced today. Referee for today's game, he'll be as nervous as anybody. 44 years of age, Roger Woolmer, tremendous refereeing experience both in the UK and here in New Zealand. It's his first Cheltenham Cup final. He's been on the line in two previous occasions, but it's his first time in the middle. And he'll be supported by Gary Fleet and Trevor Allsbrook. And there's been a very late change in this mount running side, with Dean Smith coming into the side. There's been a rumour all week that Andy Brown was suffering an injury, and he's obviously failed the fitness test, and Dean Smith takes his place at right fullback. So a late change, and that could upset the mount. And the early 20 minutes will prove that. Big day, Ricky, for Dean Smith coming in so late into the side.
I'm sure he's going to be very delighted to get a chance. John, he's waited all season. He sat on the bench very patient, and I'm sure he's going to take this opportunity.
Early foul there by Grant Light-Brown on Johan Verwey. Nonsense approach from the defensive aspects of both sides. Ronnie Armstrong there just loving the ball into touch. And the throw-in will be taken by 20-year-old Lawrence Fitzpatrick, who's unbelievably playing in his third consecutive Chatham Cup final. Gary trying to force his way through. Dangerous when McGarry gets on the flank, good cross and just edged away there by Ronnie Armstrong. Michael McGarry, one of the country's top players and certainly one of the most dangerous when he gets a run down the flank, very difficult to contain. Corner kick to be taken by Julian Falloon. Confident shooting chance well taken there by Michael Boomer, but off target. We're going to see the young players having shots so early in the game, Ricky.
I think we're going to see this all through the match, John. A very positive approach. It's a one-sir, and I'm sure both sides are going to be very, very positive.
With a bit of room for the defence, and here's a good chance for Barclay. Oh, and it's a brilliant save by Stroud, and Winnerveen gets his shot, but his shot's wide. But a first break there. Good ball played through from Grant Lightbound. The Winnerveen shot just wide of the target. There was the ball played in, and this is an excellent chance. Really, I think Barclay did everything right, Ricky.
Yes, he kept his composure, but a great save by Alan Stroud. That's going to give him a ton of confidence.
Let me see it again. Barclay played in, opened the angle, but just the legs of Stroud. People say those are lucky saves. They're not. It's a goalkeeper's job to spread himself in the box and give a bigger target as possible to the oncoming striker. There's certainly nothing wrong with the strike of Barclay. Voted last night as the media's player of the year in New Zealand. So the first chance going to Broadmount Wellington. Jennison there, calm, under pressure from Alan Carvel. Grant Schofield, no nonsense in these early stages, just punting the ball long. Matt Wellington playing into the breeze in this first half. Elegant actually wins the throw. A really strong challenge by John Lay. Both these teams, Christchurch United and Mount Wellington, have characterised New Zealand football for 21 years of the National League. This is Carvel, but defensive play by Dean Smith. A good decision making there from Grant Schofield. Came a long way through his goal line to clear that ball. Caught it well, made a very early decision. Looks to be full of confidence, Schofield. Gavigan playing on the right flank for the mount. He's failing to keep that ball in touch. Could be an interesting midfield battle developing between John Lay and Witteveen, and of course Danny Halligan and Boomer. Could be one of the interesting factors of the game. I see they're playing Braithwaite quite well up early in this game, Ricky.
They have done in the past, John. They've used Keith as more of a target man, and I think they'll settle Danny Halligan and Mike Boomer in there. It will be very interesting, because Dave Witteveen, he likes to get forward and attack, and I think Johnny Lay, he'll sit in and do the defensive role. That's going to be very tight, very interesting contest. Also notable, John, just to see Michael Rydenton dropped out to play left back. That was one of the talking points, and he has adopted that role right from the start.
Well, he's been playing so well for New Zealand in the left fullback position, and of course Michael McGarry is the most dangerous player on the Christchurch side. Probably Rydenton in man-to-man marking, he's one of the best in New Zealand. Well, there's a lovely little chip over the top of Schofield from Julian Falloon. Just left Dean Smith for pace a little bit there, but I think the credit must go to Schofield here for attacking the player so quickly, Ricky.
Yes, he's a very positive goalkeeper, John, and that tends to be the pattern at this stage. Both sides are very positive, no-nonsense football, and they're going right from back to front as early as they possibly can.
Well, there's only 6 minutes of play gone, and there's been chances at both ends already, so it's going to be too long, possibly, before we see the opening goal in this game. Kick on Johnny Lay by Danny Halligan. Would have been just trying to pinch an extra yard. This is Dean Smith. It looked to be a nice turn by Winnerveen, ruled an illegal challenge by referee Roger Woolmer. Johan Verwey playing in the, probably wouldn't like me saying it, the twilight of his career now, centre-half, but he's an international striker for New Zealand in the front positions, but he's now this season adapted a defensive role. Very, very strong player in the air, Johan Verwey. It's Patrick. A little bit of a shot there by Alan Carvel on Marty Jennison. Jennison there supporting a new haircut for today's game, Ricky.
Yes, looks very nice, John.
Adapting the Liverpool trend of Payan that plays at centre-half for Liverpool. I think probably Marty and him are around about the same age as well. Saloon sets Calder up. Well, Gavigan, nice first touch, but into touch, so he'll be a throw into Christchurch United. The experience of Ronnie Armstrong is drifting about the right-hand side of the central area of this Mount Wellington defence. Of course, all Ronnie's career has been at left full-back, but his experience allows him to be very adaptable, very experienced defender. Said coming into the team only 15 minutes before kickoff. Very big day for him since he joined the Mount a few seasons ago. He's a regular reserve team player. He's had one or two first team games, but a great servant to the club. This is Armstrong. Now to Steve Donoghue, young man that I think could possibly have a good bearing on the game today if he gets going, because he's an exceptionally talented player. Donoghue, former home of course is Wellington, so he'd be quite at home on the base in reserve. And Mount Wellington's first corner be taken from this near side by Eddie Gavigan. That Wellington probably a little bit stronger in the air than Christchurch United. What a great header by Lightbound. It's fell to Redenton. Chips the ball deep. There's Winnerveen, and he's over the bar. So Alan Stroud breathes a sigh of relief in the Christchurch United goal. It was a good header here from Lightbound. Stroud was coming for it, but Lightbound beat into it, Ricky.
Yes, I think Alan will be a bit disappointed here. We've just gone the first 10 minutes, and he's let that one slip by. Grant's put in a good challenge, and then David, the back stick, just putting over the post.
Well, this is Carvel now broke clear. The big chance here, he's gone! There's Carvel, Alan Carvel has put 3-0 Christchurch in the lead. But after 12 minutes of play, it's 3ZB Christchurch United 1, Brawn Mount Wellington 0, and that came after all the pressure from Mount Wellington, from a long ball clearance. It just fell to Alan Carvel, he drew the keeper and put the ball away. So a big start there for Christchurch United. And this good goal could really set this game alight, Ricky.
Well, ironically there, John, on that goal, Alan Stroud missing the ball down this end and then collecting and sending a long one down the other end. Mount a little bit hesitant in defence, and Alan Carvel slipping through.
Well, something that the Mount has to be aware of, because Alan Carvel does have one thing, and that is pace. And he's given something like 30, 40 yards to run to get onto the end of that ball, and he made it by a yard. And really, it was just unfortunate, certainly no reflection on Grant Schofield, because he was given no chance. So there we have it, an early goal. I think it's what the game needed, and I'm sure the supporters, I know, that are gathered in the McKinley Park club rooms and at Christchurch United, we're really now on the edge of the seats as this game set alive. It's Barkley now applying the pressure on Christchurch. His Lightbound just can't get on top of that ball. There's Julian Falloon coming clear for Christchurch. Well, Ricky, we saw that unbelievable score yesterday. Man Utd was 7 and Hutt Valley 1. And I believe that Gisborne have been rattling 5 or 6 goals against, will they play Miramar today? So it's been 2 very high scoring games yesterday and this morning here in Christchurch. Do you think we're going to see another one today?
Possibly could be, John. It'd be very interesting to see 4 or 5 goals. I think both sides, as I said before, they've got through that nervous sort of 10, 15 minutes, and I think the goals really sparked them now. We could be in for a very, very good match.
We'll see the strength of the sunshine here in Wellington today. Strong glare on the Winfield signs, that could affect the players, Ricky. It's so it's affecting us up here in the commentary box.
I think that could be a small factor, John. It's obviously the Mount playing into the sun, and perhaps this is why they've got this sort of no-nonsense approach.
We can't see the angle that Grant Schofield's on, but if the same angle is affecting him, it could give the goalkeeper all sorts of problems. Tidied up by Ronnie Armstrong. Well, the only indications are that we could see a lot of goals today, because four players on the field today are in the top eight goal scorers in the country this season. Barkley, of course, leading that race is 17, and then for Christchurch United, Carvel on 14, McGarry's got 12, and Braithwaite 10. So plenty of players, certainly in the Christchurch side, used to scoring plenty of goals. Corner, but it's Roger Woolmer says no. The ball cannoned off Michael Boomer. There is the Mount Wellington bench. Bryce Hastings, the physio, David Taylor in the middle, and Evan Teal, the assistant to David Taylor, on the right hand side. Certainly David looking a little bit pensive. This is a member of the team that played against Christchurch United way back in 1972. Here's Witteveen. To O'Donoghue. Looking for the angle, but does well and forces another corner kick. And I do feel this is one of the areas of play, Ricky, that the Mount will dominate this afternoon if Gavigan does give good delivery into the box from these corner kicks.
Exactly, John. I think Mount do have the quality flank players in Eddie Gavigan and Steve O'Donoghue, but it's a matter of just producing the goods. As you say, they've got to be quality deliveries.
Again for Lybro, this time Stryer gets a hand to it, falls to Johnny Lay, first time falls. Certainly Alex Stroud in the right place at the right time on that occasion. Good distribution from Stroud, finding Michael McGarry. To here again. It's cut out by John Lay and brought away now by Stephen Donoghue. Certainly the Mount's been playing a lot of long ball in this early stages. Okay, they are going into the wind, but it's not really the style. They're usually a side that gets it down and wants to play.
Yes, from the few times I've seen them play this season, John, they've liked to play out from the back. Grant Scofield likes to throw, and the fullbacks do get wide, and they like to attack down the flanks. But they have adopted a different approach in this. Maybe with it being a cup final, they see it a little bit different, but or maybe the wind is a strong factor. But, normally they do like to play a lot more football there.
Braithwaite now breaking forward, got support from Boomer. That's a good tackle by John Lane, a lovely turn by David Witteveen. He's got light bound out wide, but couldn't bend the ball out there. Spurway under a little bit of pressure from light bound. Light bound finally brings him down. Possibly in David Taylor's defence, he's been forced to make some changes, especially in the back four, now with Redemption playing at left full-back and Dean Smith coming in late. So, and of course, Lightbound hasn't played for about 6 weeks. He's been out through suspension, and probably a gamble there by David Taylor, bringing him in for a game like this when he hasn't played for 5 or 6 weeks, Ricky.
Yes, I think it's not an easy task for young Dean to come in, but I've seen him play on a few occasions and he's more than capable of doing the job. But he'll be very, very nervous coming in, and it is a big occasion for him, but I'm sure he's relishing the challenge, and he'll come through with flying colours. I believe he's got a good future.
Another receiving by Noel Barclay. Little touch. Pushed by Johan Verwey on light bound. Winnevean, I think this is probably just outside his shooting range, but you can never tell with this man. He does possess one of the hardest shots in New Zealand football. And certainly, Fizovic Chrysio is giving him the respect with a four-man wall from that distance. Donoghue chips in, looking for Jennison. It's safely collected by Helen Stroud. Strong comment there by Roger Woolmer. As we said, we fancied this to be a little bit of a battle between Halligan and John Lane. There's been one or two little bits of niggles going on off the ball, and it's not gone unseen by the referee. And he's made his point.
You've got to talk in there.
It's a good refereeing there by Roger Woolmer, not flashing yellow cards. He's a very sensible approach to the game.
I think so, John. I think, you know, referees have got to make firm standings, and I think by flashing yellow cards willy-nilly at the start of the game doesn't entice anything. We've got to set the pattern and then take it from there.
Slight bounce pace, they're going to go side, and he's going in! Oh, and it's an unbelievable goal! Now, who's got it? Grant Lightbound was there. But it looks as if he was probably a foot from the Orange Blue way. But certainly the pressure that was put on him by the pace of Lightbound there was exceptional, because they had 2 yards on Lightbound. Here we see it, Lightbound gets goal side, but it was certainly Burway's boot. And he's dropped just under the crossbar. An amazing goal, but this game is really alight, Ricky.
Well, here we go, John. Oh, amazing goal. I think, as you say, the pressure put on there by Grant. Alan Stroud coming out to perhaps collect the ball from Yeo, but wasn't quite quick enough to reach it. Got a toe on the end of it, and whoops, over the top we go.
Well, that is the game. I mean, it was a ball that Burway had to play, because Lightbound certainly would have been goal side of him and in possession of the ball. Stroud had to come. So once again, there is certainly no fault with the goalkeeping. Stroud did everything right, but certainly just pace and attitude and commitment there from Lightbound has got Mount Wellington back on even terms. We're looking around about 22 minutes of this game gone in the first half. And it's now 3ZB Christchurch 1, Bromont Wellington 1, and this could be some cup final.
I think probably, John, with the return of Grant Brown to the Light Brown to the striking force of the Mount Wellington team is certainly a pleasing aspect for Dave Taylor. He's been out for a long while, and he'll be expecting a lot from Grant.
Well, it's certainly, like I said, it possibly was a gamble by David Taylor to play Grant Lightbound today, but certainly less than 25 minutes gone, and Lightbound certainly justified his appearance here today and his selection. Oh, there's a ball that floated across the wind. It looked to be misread by Grant Schofield, but it drifted safely into touch. Probably got a fingertip touch, and it's a corner to Christchurch. He's certainly caught underneath the ball. So there's action here at both ends. It's a tremendous game in these early stages. This is Falloon. Good block there by John Lay. His body behind the ball. Pass from Gavigan, trying to get Michael Redenton away, so it's drifted back in. There's Jennison, dominant as ever in the air, in the centre of the Mount Wellington defence. Calder, what a lovely touch from Carville! And Braithwaite turned on the ball, and Braithwaite is so well known for those goals in and around the 6-yard box. He's so quick, but he just couldn't get the power on the ball on that occasion. Just drifted in, turned well, couldn't get the power on the finish. There was that ball, lovely touch from Carville, Ricky.
Gets a nice little flick on at the near post there, John, and unfortunately for Keith, just unable to make a good enough contact.
Carville a little bit high with his foot there, and parted Jennison's new hairdo right down the middle there, Ricky.
Yes, I don't think Marty would be too impressed with that.
I think Carvel's got a new haircut as well. He's taken off a lot more hair than last time I saw him. There's Barkley trying to get goal side. What a strong shot by Gannigan, but wide of the post. The interesting factor here is, you see the shot from Gannigan, really rifled it, trying to bend it with the outside of his boot. Just didn't make the right contact. But Ricky, it's been the action in the goalmouth. We're not seeing too much of slow midfield plays like we might have expected from these two footballing sides. But tremendous value to the spectators because everything's happening in the box.
I think so, John, and that's where we're going to see the goals. It doesn't appear to be, again, as you say, it's going to be long, slow build up from the back. Everything's very, very positive. Long balls put in as soon as they can from defence. And it's these 6-yard instances that I think are going to be the crucial factors.
There's Michael McGarry, number 7. He was voted the players' player of the year last night. This is where he's at his best. Skillsy skills. And a good decision there. And he's in the post. And there's Harry Gideon wide. Oh, and it's all happening here at the Basin Reserve. And I must, I think, the game needs to pay a tribute there. First to Gary Fleet, the linesman, and to referee Roger Mulmer for letting that play go on. Because first of all, Michael McGarry was certainly fouled. He let the play go on. The cross came into Julian Falloon. He headed against the post, and Halligan hit the shot wide. There was the foul. Good decision by the officials. Far post, hit the post, Julian Falloon. Fell to Halligan, and he played the ball wide. So this is quite exceptional. I mean, both sides have had 3 or 4 now. Excellent chances in front of goal. And this is what cup finals should be about. And today, these two teams are certainly producing the goods. Absolutely tremendous first half, Ricky. I thought we saw a good game at Eden Park yesterday in the first half, but I think this is living up to even Auckland's performance against Otago.
I was just about to say, John, this is turning into a tremendous match. Who needs to sit home and watch the rugby league? This has got everything. Instances in the box, we've got players really, really fired up and committed here today. It's great to see.
David would have been looking very innocent there, but certainly a loose elbow caught Michael McGarry on the end of the nose. Well, a little bit of a slight little cut, but I think that'll spur McGarry into even more effort, and he's certainly been giving tremendous effort in this opening 30 minutes. And a nice little word there to David Winnevine's ear from referee Roger Woolmer. And certainly the officials are well in control and really handling this game in superb fashion today. And it is the officials, I think, that often make or break games. And certainly I think the three men in black today are playing their part today. He's looking for Gannigan. Possibly the flanks of Gannigan there is playing a little bit too in towards the centre. I'd like to see Gannigan probably playing a little bit wider, Ricky. Would have been didn't have a big target to hit then.
Yes, I think Dave's broken well there from the midfield, and Eddie has brought himself more into a central position. I think that if they could have gone another step through the midfield, a 20-yard ball rather than trying a 40-yard ball, Eddie might have been able to pick up a better position out wide.
Well, with the action being in and around the penalty areas, it's a habit that flank players can get into, to start edging further and further into the centre of the field of play. But when the side breaks, they usually like to find men out wide. Kick to Bromart Wellington. Johnny Lane leads in, and playing all the races now, the man, because they've pushed Jennison forward. And this will be Dean Smith to take the free kick. Here's the light bound.
Feet out,
make sure. It's in. Under a lot of pressure. Redemption. Forced back to Ronnie Armstrong. Now Jan chance for Three Zippy Christchurch to break quickly. Pete Smith as well on the cover. Lovely ball from Donoghue into Barclay, but that was very well put out indeed by Michael Fullan, because that was a good header from Barclay looking for his striking partner Grant Lightburn. Certainly Dean Smith has a lot of faith in the Lions, because he saw the flag up and told he thought to play, Ricky.
Yes, he had all faith in the linesman there.
So 30 minutes of play gone in this first half. Very exciting game here at the Basin Reserve. 3 Zebby Christchurch 1, Broadmoat Wellington 1. He's got space and Barclay ahead of him. Here's Barclay. Looks to be a pass, it's Donoghue. Another wonderful piece of football by Mount Wellington. But you don't get a chance to settle in this game. The ball's immediately down the other end of the field. There's certainly some quality football being played here today. Immediately back down. This is just quite incredible. This is right down.
I think what we're really seeing now, John, is a bit more of a composed Mount Wellington side. Twice now they've broken, twice had opportunities by being a little bit patient and deciding to play the ball.
Well, it's just the ball side to getting forward so quickly, it's hard to give credit to the attacking moves. Certainly that one last run of the mount, because of Donoghue's run after he played Barclay in to get onto the near post, was nothing short of superb. McGarry made the challenge. Scoville just too quick. There we see McGarry closing in. Oh, good 50-50 ball, but just left the boot there and caught Schofield as he collected the ball. There you saw the left boot going on the head of Grant Schofield. Let's hope that's not a serious injury. Schofield down, Jennison getting a little drink. Certainly a different game. This beautiful crowd, large crowd here today at the base, and relax in the sunshine on the bank. But the mount last year in 1982 when they beat Miramar by 1-0 in a game that did you play in that one, Ricky?
Yes, I played in that one, John. Unfortunately came off in the second half with an ankle injury, but I have fond memories of that one.
Certainly I don't think it had this intensity and excitement of this game. I certainly a little smile there on David Taylor's face and Evan Teal.
Oh, I'm sure John, Dave's really, really enjoying this game. He'll be very nervous, but it's obviously his first cup final, and he's done a wonderful job this year with the side, and I'm sure he's really enjoying every second.
It looks like Bryce Hastings has got Schofield back on his feet. And of course, there is the Christchurch United bench, the receiving hairline of Martin Stewart, the Christchurch United coach. Looking very dapper, very relaxed. Big day for him today, his first Chatham Cup final. Ben Schofield not looking 100%, but got a long punt upfield. He's stayed on the edge of his penalty area, but I'm sure he'll be all right. So we're back down to the Christchurch United penalty area, where Grant Lightburn will look for a long throw in and probably target men with Dave Winnerveen and Marty Jennison. That's ruled to be an illegal throw. So the opportunity is wasted. Trevor Osbrook, the linesman with the yellow flag from Wellington. Pushed there by Braithwaite on Eddie Gannigan. Eddie, of course, I think played in the Scottish Cup final at Hampden Park some many years ago. Much different environment to this one, but I'm sure he's just as excited. Johnny Lay with a free kick. That looks like Alan Strouds, and it is. Really, with the strength that Mount Wellington have, Ricky, you've got to get those deliveries a little bit shorter. It's not a safe ball for the goalkeeper to come and catch.
Well, I think Noel Barkley could be the key figure here, John. He has shown on numerous occasions to come short, and perhaps a little ball into his feet inside the box may be a better bet. Although they do have the weapons in Martin Jennison and Michael Rod Denton, who are very good players in the air.
It's a header from Michael Redenton, but it looked like Michael Fuller came right through, and Barkley is still on the ground. I don't think it's any secret that Barkley's been carrying one or two injuries because of these challenges that have been coming, raking the back of his legs. And certainly Roger Woolman didn't spot that one, but it's a strong challenge there by Michael Fullen on Barkley, and let's hope that he can continue. As Ricky has just said, he's an integral part of this Mount Wellington attack. So a busy first half for Bryce Hastings, his third visit to the pitch. Some of the characters on the field today, it's quite interesting to note that Ronnie Armstrong was in his second season of the National League when Lawrence Fitzpatrick was born. He's playing a right fullback today for Christchurch United, and Ronnie today is going for his fifth Challenge Cup winners medal, and Lawrence Fitzpatrick already has two and going for his third at 20 years of age. So there we are, Ronnie Armstrong, 2 years experience in this league before this young man Fitzpatrick was born. Well tidied up by Kerry Coley, because that was a pressure header from Verwey. Gavigan was trying to get through. Lovely turn by Barkley. He's got Gavigan wide. Players are queuing up in the box. Knife, Gavigan can get the cross in. He's got support from Dean Smith. Smith crosses into Barkley. Looking to jink and turn. There's the shot from Barkley. It's a beautiful goal. It's a magnificent goal from Noel Barkley. And drawn Mount Wellington go into the lead after being a goal down after 12 minutes. Barkley has put his team into the lead. With a brilliant shot, Ricky.
Well, I think that's just what we're saying, John. You get the ball into Noel Barkley's feet in the box, and he is lethal. That is a tremendous strike. He's turned, he's curled it in with his left foot, and left Alan Stroud sprawling on the ground. Tremendous goal from a tremendous player.
Well, it shows the true skills and techniques of the game, and he's delighted with it, and so he should be, because when he turned and was in ball possession, he picked his spot and put the ball, placed it exactly where he wanted it. So here we are. Around about 40 minutes of play gone in this first half. Mount Wellington now in the lead by 2-1. And the players immediately down the other end of the field with a free kick in a very attacking position here. And Michael McGarry can score from here because he can hit a ball, he can bend a ball. And Greg Schofield is really going to have to be on his toes. There was, he tried to place it, didn't have the power. Schofield well positioned. certainly we've been treated to an absolutely magnificent game of attacking football here today. It's all credit to Bournemouth Wellington, Ricky. I mean, a goal down after 12 minutes. They've come back with a lot of character so early in the piece.
We've seen this trade, John, through the season. They were behind against Hutt Valley and got back in the last couple of minutes, then went on to win an extra time. They've got the players. They've got the players that have been through these situations before that know it's a 90-minute game. But all credit to them. They've bounced back and they certainly, I think, are starting to dominate.
He's pushing up, Gino. Keep it going.
Concern there from David Taylor. He wants obviously his players to keep the attacking trio of Christchurch United very tight now. 5 minutes to go before half time. It would be a tremendous boost for 3-0 Christchurch if they could get a goal in this last 5 minutes. Questionable those situations, Ricky. I mean, the goalkeepers, maybe rightly so, are protected, but I couldn't see anything other than Redenton going for that ball there.
I tend to think so as well, John. I think a goalkeeper, he can jump up with his arms and come up with his knees, but unfortunately, the player like that, Michael, I think he's gone up with an honest challenge and he's been punished for it.
Championship wrestling, I think, there, Ricky. Barking is well and truly sandwiched.
It's certainly a good sandwich, that one.
It's a good run by Lightbound. Once again, just these little touches in the back for silly offences to make, because Lightbound was always going to be in possession of that ball, and it's these little touches that can really put you in trouble, and this is now a very good attacking situation for Mount Wellington. Stephen Donoghue with a free kick, and there's Lightbound! Oh, and Lightbound just couldn't hit the full face of the forehead on the board. It was a glancing header that just shot wide of the post.
Yes, here we have it. It's a good ball in from Steve. Grant's made a good run from 3 or 4 yards out, and just a glancing header. He'll be a little bit disappointed, but at least he's got himself into a position to have the opportunity of scoring.
With the free kick. Carvel looking for support. Chance now for Mark Wellington to break. Balls fell nicely for Barclay. Support. He has good shape to Mark Wellington at the moment. John Lay trying one of his dynamic shots, but I don't think we can classify that as one of his more powerful ones.
He's had an honest attempt there, John. I think it's, once again, he'll be disappointed, but the people are trying things, and like I said before, I think Mount Wellington has starting to dominate this game. They're getting back into their natural stride of wanting to play good football and knocking it round and eliminating a lot of the long ball game.
Go on, Mike!
Come on, rip it down!
Red ball!
Sleep!
Drop two, that'll be it!
This is young Fitzpatrick.
Yeah, steady, low, steady.
Come on,
Mike, hold it.
Johnny Light.
Come on.
John there, a little bit late with that challenge. And Michael Boomer. Just coming to the end now of this first half. Probably Christchurch's last attacking chance. It's Patrick. Drifts the ball in. Schofield's come. Half a punch. The ball's thumped into touch by John Lay. Correct no-nonsense approach at this stage of the game by players in defensive positions. Redenton. Barkley pressurises Fullen all the way back to his goalkeeper. Elegant and McGarry. This is always a dangerous partnership when these two start to combine. Once again, fine defensive work by Michael Redenton. We're into injury time here now in this first half. Now Wellington look to hold on to this 2-1 lead. Halligan with a tremendous volley, but he just can't get it on target. It can enough. David Winnerveen, so it'll be a corner kick. So the pressure is really on the mount in these closing stages of this first half. Certainly, Julian Falloon wasting no time with a corner kick. He's aware of the time. Let's turn. Here's a chance. Oh, it was Winnerveen that blocked it. Danny Halligan has found himself on the back post with a header. And Winnerveen got in the way. And there is the half-time whistle. So, Ricky, a tremendous first half, really, from both sides.
Exactly, John, I think so. Christchurch got off to a great start there with Alan Carvel, and all credit to Matt Wellington. They've got back into the game. They're leading now 2-1 at the break. And I think from both points of view, I think both coaches have been reasonably satisfied. We've seen some good entertaining football and good goal-mouth scrambles. It is. It's a very, very entertaining match.
Well, here we are then. 2-1 to Broadmount Wellington here at half-time. And it's been a marvellous game of football. The sun is shining, and I'm sure we're going to see the same sort of entertainment in the second half.
Rod Pickard. Well, down here on the sideline, recapping on that first half of this Chatham Cup final. Christchurch hit the front after 10.5 minutes. A breakout, and Alan Carvel put the ball in the back of the net. But the mount hits straight back, 23 minutes into the match, the equaliser, and real drama again for that Christchurch defence. Of course, pressure coming in there, and it was Johan Verwey trying to clear things up for Christchurch, but the ball, in fact, going back over his own goalkeeper, Alan Stroud's head. So tragedy for Christchurch, the goalkeeper beaten by one of his own defenders, not for the first time this season. We go to the goal that put Mount Wellington in front, and it was their key player, Noel Barclay, who'd been injured just minutes before, beating the keeper, superb shot. 2-1 to the mount, that goal 39 minutes into the first half, so the mount leading 2-1 at half time. Of course, that was a result of their match last weekend when they played. Well, now joining us sideline for expert comment, a man who knows that Christchurch United team inside out, Steve Sumner. You of course played for Christchurch United in the final last year. They won that one easily, 7-1, but much different sort of game here today. Has Christchurch got the mettle to come back in the second half?
Well, it's a cup final, anything can happen. And it's the pace of Carvel and the pace of McGarry that are going to cause them problems. And particularly Carvel, because in the middle at the back, Mount Wellington aren't that quick. And the same really applies for Mount Wellington. If they can get the ball forward to Lightbound, he's causing Christchurch heaps of problems at the back as well. So it's still a ball game. There's a long time to go.
As far as cup finals rate, how does this one stack up?
Well, I think they're all exciting. They've all got something about about them, and the goal that Noel Barkley scored, I mean, you won't see better anywhere in the world. Superb goal scored by New Zealand's player of the year, marvellous goal.
And a minute after, he looked to be in some trouble too. He's really resilient, isn't he?
Well, he's a good player. I mean, you don't get voted New Zealand's player of the year for nothing, and he's done that again today. Showed great goal. And, an interesting contest is in the middle of the park where Johnny Lay has gone straight onto Danny Halligan and tried to unsettle him a bit, and he's doing a fair job on it. And they've tried to get Dave Witteveen free, and, that's working to some degree as well for Mount Wellington.
What about the atmosphere here today? Of course, it's a neutral ground. How do the players relate to that?
Well, from my point of view, I never bothered. It didn't matter at all. All I wanted to do was just play the game and pick up a medal at the end of the day. It's a little bit disappointed the crowd's not as big as what perhaps people would have expected, but really all that counts now is that piece of silver over there in the next 45 minutes.
Steve, you got a good tan. You've travelled quite a long way to be here today.
I've had a tough night. I travelled from Hawaii, but I mean, I'm not going to complain about that.
And finally then, 45 minutes left to go in this match when we come back for the second half. What does Christchurch have to do to get back into this match?
I think you've still got to look to play Carvalho early, very early. And preferably over the top, and this time they can knock the ball a little bit longer because of playing into the wind, so it'll hold up for Carvel, and he's got the pace to do things behind the back. But right now, I mean, the fortune favours Mount Wellington.
If we can put you on the spot though, a final score?
Well, I don't think the goals are finished yet. I think you might see something like 3-2 or maybe 4-2.
But to Mount Wellington at this stage?
Well, it's looking that way, yes.
Steve Sumner, thanks very much indeed for your time.
Okay.
We'll be back after the break.
Welcome back to a sun-drenched Basin Reserve. We're during the half-time break. We're looking at a frisbee soccer competition going on, which is terribly exciting. There's been some tremendous action. It's a long time since we've seen a game that really has been played in the penalty areas of both goals. Alan Carvel scored the first goal after only 10 minutes of play. And it was a long ball after there's been tremendous pressure on the Christchurch goal. And here, Verwey equalised Carvel's goal with an own goal, put under tremendous pressure by Grant Lightbound, as Lightbound's pace got him goal side. And so it was a tremendous break, and then we saw Mount Wellington go in front with one of the superb goals of the season. It was scored by Player of the Year, Noel Barkley. Here he's under tremendous pressure here. He's twisting and turning, he's keeping ball possession, and finally he gets the space that he wants and really picked a spot with unbelievable accuracy to give goalkeeper Alan Stroud absolutely no chance at all. It was a superb goal, and he was obviously delighted with it. So we've seen a tremendously exciting game, Ricky. Of course, we've got Ricky Herbert with me, the former All Whites captain. And Ricky, it's a long time since we've seen this sort of football.
Exactly, John. I've been fortunate to play in three myself, and although they were very, very good games, I think we are seeing today a very entertaining and a match very worthwhile watching.
Interesting to note that really both sides have decided to bypass midfield on a number of occasions and really just want to get the ball into the box and score goals. And this is really tremendous for this sort of football because it's a one-off, and they're here to entertain the public, and they're certainly doing that.
Exactly. I think in Christchurch's case, they have the pace of Alan Carvel and the ability of Mike McGarry, and I think by bypassing that, they're getting balls into them directly. And with Mount Wellington, they have the ability, as we've seen, of Noel Barkley and the pace of Grant Lightbrown. Tremendous pace, and I think this is the way both sides are adapting and adopting the style of play.
Well, certainly we've seen some brave decisions by David Taylor, switching Michael Redenton to left fullback, having to bring Dean Smith in at right fullback. So it really has been a complicated game for the Mount, but they've settled down very well. And I think down on the touchline now, we've got Stephen Stewart with a very special guest. I think it's Ricky Morris down there.
Well, here we are down on the sideline. We've spoken to, of course, a Christchurch supporter and Steve Sumner. Now time to hear the Mount Wellington's perspective from musician Ricky Morris and TV presenter, of course. Ricky, you're a bit of a secret soccer fan, are you?
Yeah, I love it. Always loved it. Used to play when I was a kid, you know, but not anymore. I'm too lazy now.
Now, you're off to Australia tomorrow, but you've taken time out to rush down here today. Has the trip been worthwhile?
So far, yeah. I mean, a goal like that, the second goal. Was it Noel who scored it, I think? Yeah.
Sure was. Leading by example.
Absolute corker. He's a great player. Great team. Got my fingers crossed.
How long have you been a Mount supporter?
Well, I used to play for Eastern Suburbs, which is sort of out around Mount Wellington. So now that Eastern Suburbs aren't doing too well, I thought I'll go over to the other side.
Well, are the Liverpool of New Zealand football, aren't they? Can they take this match out?
I think so, yeah. And I think they'll win the double. I really do. They're a great team.
Highlights for you of that first half, other than Noel's goal there, any other features?
Nice to see Grant Lightbound back. It really is. He's a great player too.
Now, Ricky, of course, we mentioned earlier, you're off to Australia tomorrow. In what capacity? What takes you across the ditch?
Well, I've just signed a publishing deal with Mushroom Music over there, so I'm off to write songs for people, basically, and try and further my musical career. So,
what about a couple of bars of the Mounts soccer anthem?
What about, here we go, here we go, here we go, we're going to win.
Ricky Morris, thanks very much indeed. We return to our commentators after the break.
Well, we see the Mount Wellington and the Christchurch United teams coming back onto the field of play, and I'm sure the whole New Zealand wishes Ricky Morris all the very best in his new career in Australia. Has been a stalwart of the Mount for many years, and there is Noel Barclay, and he'll be looking not to sit back probably on that one goal, Ricky, but I'm sure Barclay will be looking for more.
No, Noel's a very ambitious player, John, and I'm sure he'll be looking to perhaps get a second or perhaps finish this season off with a hat-trick.
Well, he certainly is ambitious. Last night, Tony Lowes was given the Golden Boot Award, the Winfield Golden Boot Award, for scoring 26 goals this season. Barkley's only got 17, so he's 9 behind Tony Lowes at this stage. But, of course, Mount Wellington do come back to Wellington on Tuesday to play the last league game of the season. And if Noel happens to get 9 or 10 in one game, it could be quite embarrassing.
Well, nothing would surprise me with Noel. He does have the ability, and the way the Mount Wellington side is playing at the moment, perhaps 9 goals not without without happening.
Well, here we are now, primed for this second half after a tremendously exciting first half. 3 goals in it. Carvel putting Christchurch United into the lead after 10 minutes. Burway's own goal, and Barclay's superb effort to put Mount Wellington 2-1 in the lead. And Roger Woolmer gets this second half underway, and the sun shining brightly into the eyes of Grant Schofield in this half. But Mount Wellington do have the breeze in their favour. Certainly not a strong wind here today, but certainly for players like Dave Winneveen, this could be an exciting half for him, because we've said his confidence builds when he's got a bit of wind up his back, and he does possess a very powerful shot indeed. The exchange is just a little bit scrappy. Elegant taking a knock there from David Winneveen. Big Red is as affectionately known. His hair colouring. Superb player, Halligan. Regular member of the All Whites as well, so quite an array of internationals on the field today. Winneveen in strongly, and this is John Lay. This time he's returned on Lay by Danny Halligan himself. Certainly the Mount syndication are, Ricky, they're going for goals, they're pushing Jennison, and all the big men are going forward, Redenton, for this free kick.
I think so, John. I think if they score one more, I think that would be sufficient.
Donoghue, Jennison! And it was Barclay coming in, but Alan Stroud beat him to the wall. This is where Christchurch United can be dangerous on the break. Broken out by Ronnie Armstrong. Silky skills by him. That was a good ball played forward by Dean Smith into the path of Lightbound. It was Johan Verwey there, number 14, forced to play the ball into touch. Lightbound will take the throw-in. In the background there is Gary Fleet, who has voted the referee of the year, and that is a very proud award for Gary Fleet last night at the media awards ceremony. You hear the Christchurch United players now, just a wee bit of frustration maybe creeping in to Christchurch's defenders at this stage, Ricky.
We've had one or two sort of niggly instances, John, in the middle of the park, and I think a couple of players, mainly from the Christchurch side, maybe with them being 2-1 down, are getting a little bit frustrated. And I think they've just got to forget those things and get on with the game.
Redemption beaten by McGarry. Thank you, Still, we're not seeing either of these sides wanting to play out from the back, and both of them do it very well indeed, but today is Cup final day, and there's certainly no risk being taken at all. Patrick just overhits his ball, looking for Alan Corbell. The ball's fell to Winnevine, who's tripped from behind by Michael Boomer. Barkley prevented from turning by Michael Fullan. Plenty of work for Roger Woolmer in this opening 5 minutes of the second half. And once again, the Mount push everybody forward. Armstrong drifts it in. This is Gavigan. Into Barkley, and then that'll be a corner kick to Brown Mount Wellington. Michael Fullan with the challenge, and the corner kick will be taken by Eddie Gavigan. Mount Wellington looked dangerous on these set plays early in the first half. Occasion, a good challenge by Stroud. It's a lovely touch by Noel Barkley. John Lane very strongly indeed. Mount Wellington not just being able to find their own players at this moment of time.
Stay with them, mate, stay with them.
Tennyson in quickly. Donoghue with a bit of space. Well, there's a chance here if Winnevine gets it onto his right foot, which he does. It's a powerful shot, but wide of the post. Just the wrong angle there for Winnevine.
Just a little bit off balance here, John.
So we certainly know that he can score from that distance.
Well, this boy can really hit him. We've heard it before, and he certainly does strike a good ball.
He's caught the ball on the outside. He's always drifting away from the Christchurch United goal.
I think one thing we're seeing, John, and that's the with the inclusion of John Lane in the middle of the park, I think he's having a tremendous game. He's having to do the donkey work against the international Danny Halligan, and I think he's been very equal to the task.
Yes, he's certainly a very strong player, is John Lane. Uncompromising, fair player. He's on the ball now, looks for an early ball in. Finds O'Donoghue. O'Donoghue can't get the cross in. Second opportunity. It's the ball into Lightbound. This is Winnevine. And Christchurch now looking to break quickly through Danny Halligan, but a complete misunderstanding between him and Michael McGarry. And there's Redenton giving a ball away. Both sides now just need to settle down and look to keep possession. Could be dangerous, he's got Coleman in the box, he's got one! And that was an unbelievable save, the danger's not been cleared, it's wide into the post! Right, well, the light didn't go up, but the light has been stood there, the referee blew the whistle, and that was drama. Here we see it with McGarry's brilliant cross, here's Carville, and a superb save by Schofield. And it's Carville who's probably... As Carvel certainly wasn't offside, whether it was a hand challenge by Braithwaite as he went in. It looked like handball by Braithwaite. But certainly tremendous drama there, Ricky.
Oh, one can't sit still here, John. It's action at both ends, as you say, and very lively. Here we have a ball in. Alan Carville, he'll be very, very disappointed. He hasn't put that open chance away, but Grant Schofield, a tremendous save. He spread himself, he stopped the shot. Keith Braithwaite following up, unfortunately, knocking the ball wide with his hands. Tremendous action, John. This is thrilling stuff.
Offside given there. I think that's probably around about the first offside decision we've seen throughout this game, Ricky, which shows good skillful running by both sets of players.
Exactly.
Gavin looking to create some room, but he's fouled by Kevin Calder. Once again, we'll see the big man of the mound push forward. I think Gallagher will deliver the free kick. Clearance by Carville. Here's Lay again, very strong, he's with a bead. Oh, what a brilliant save by Alex Brown. The ball's still alive, he's done it here, racing out. Post looking to get the cross back in. There's plenty of players in the penalty area. Winnerbean heads it down. Finally cleared by Michael Fullan, but there's tremendous saves now from both goalkeepers early in the second half. Certainly, if you want to see action, the Basin Reserve is the place to be today. Great attack by Bromart Wellington. Here's Winnerbean's shot. Certainly going in, Ricky.
Yes, I think they might have snuck in the top corner, John. It was a good save from Alan Stroud. Once again, Grant Lightbrand getting a shot away. It is. It's all action packed.
New Zealand's not a country that runs a statistical program such as the United States, but if we did, I'm sure the stats boys would have been tremendously busy this afternoon. That will be a yellow card for David Winnerbean. And one can't fault Roger Woolman for that, Ricky. Alex, you know, you do need to get a card out if you want to, you know, make a point. He's given a lot of leeway today. He's handled the game extremely well.
Yes, he's been very patient, John, and I think possibly, unfortunately for Dave, he's the one that's, that Roger said, well, this is it, you're going in the book. And I think from now on he set a precedent, and I think other names will go in and yellow cards will be shown.
Calder with a free kick. It's McGarry. Whips in a beautiful cross, McGarry. Johnny Lay again. Magnificent in defence. Brilliant defensive header from John Lay. Good work there between Lightbound and Gavigan. Redemption again. Donoghue can't control the ball. Back to McGarry. There they are, tremendous tussle between those two, McGarry and Redenton this afternoon. Redenton at the moment just having the edge. Carver looking to turn, he does so! Some space, got it onto his left foot and drove the ball low past Grant Schofield. Question marks in the Mark Wellington defence. Here is the build up. Got the space, turned it inside and beat Schofield on the near post.
Yes, one can only say, John, once again, a good ball into a player's feet, giving him the opportunity to produce the quality, and Alan Carville right on the mark with his left peg. One can only say, John, I guess everybody will be winning an Alan Carville haircut in Christchurch.
Well, there is Alan Carville, new haircut, delighted. He's brought 3ZB Christchurch back into the game. Yeah. 13 minutes gone in this second half, and the end-to-end confrontation between these two sides continues. Alan Carville getting his second goal of the game, bringing his team back into contention. Once again, it was a brilliant break by Christchurch. There's been some superb attacking play from both sides. And once again, we're evenly balanced. Gary gets the cross in. Over the head of Falloon. He kicks it back, but this one's over the top. Mount Wellington now breathe a sigh of relief. The pressure is coming thick and fast, Ricky.
Oh, exactly, John. Michael McGarry's starting to get a little bit of room out on the right-hand side. Alan Carville's, as we've said, he's got a ton of pace and he's looking very, very lively.
Put you under the eye.
Got it, Stuart, there. Another Christchurch bench. Braithwaite, one of the veterans of the side, and a more pensive approach on the Royal Mount Wellington bench. Coach David Taylor in the centre.
One can only think, John, what's going to come next. We've seen great goals here, and I don't think we've seen the end of it yet.
Even if you're a betting man, I would like to put money on the outcome of this game. Certainly in the first 15 minutes, it's been Christchurch that's dominated, but certainly Stroud has had to make at least one magnificent save. But it was Mark Wellington that dominated the final period of the first half. Christchurch have really bounced back in this second. Levine being forced to defend. It's been a tactical switch by the Marble. We've got Grant Lightbaum playing deep on the right-hand side now, with Eddie Gavigan being pushed up the middle alongside Noel Barclay. It's again Johnny Lay winning everything in the midfield. This time his header's just too strong. Your question mark, do you think, on Lightbound about his fitness, Ricky? He hasn't played for 5 weeks.
Well, he's probably going to feel the pinch, John. This has been a very, very hectic pace they've played at. And I think Grant, he's been out for that length of time. Dave will probably look to maybe inject somebody new in there.
Interesting run by Julian Falloon. He gets it clear, nice Barclay. He's got Lightbound outside him. Here is Lightbound. Looking to get an angle for the cross. There is a cross, it's Barclay! Oh, and it's headed off the line by Murray. For the Mount comeback. Barclay hands on hips. Disappointed. Lovely little turn and cross there by Lightbound. And full marks really to Burway for getting in position.
Exactly, John. He's done a good defensive job there, and once again, an identical move that Christchurch had in the first half.
Gavigan delivers. He's got Stroud stretching.
Hold on! Run!
The challenge by Lightbound. There's a cross. Winnerbean. Oh! Ricky said what is going to happen next, because his chances being created by some excellent football. There's right bounce cross, Parky leaves it. I think Winnerbean was looking for the chest of the volley, but the ball dropped quickly.
Just wouldn't come down quick enough for him, John. A little bit unlucky, but oh, what makes you feel like wish you're out there playing? This is a tremendous game.
Well, even at my age, I wouldn't mind being down there this afternoon, Ricky.
Well, you've been known to have the odd game, John.
Yes, indeed. Finally pushed by Barclay from the corner. The pressure's relieved, and the professional manager just letting everything be caused up here. He's certainly hectic. Yeah. Seen the marathon finish that we saw in the last time these two teams met when it went to two replays, because today if the scores all level at full time there will be 15 minutes each way of extra time, and then rightly or wrongly the game will be decided if the scores are still level by a penalty shootout. But from what we've seen already, Ricky, I can't see that emanating at 2-2.
No, I think there's more goals to come, John, and you'd have to be a brave man to have a bet on the game now.
That's a nasty challenge on Noel Barkley by Yohan Buwe.
This is where it's frustrating, John, and one can only feel sorry for Noel. He's had three or four of those challenges, and once again, the culprits, he's got three.
Certainly a rule that this season FIFA's tidied up in the European leagues. Barkley looks like he's going to take the free kick himself. Turns it back to Donaghy. He's got a good left foot, this man. Cannon's back to Barkley. Defended by Julian Galou. It's finally brought down. The action moves very quickly to the other end of the field. Kick commences with a free kick, and we've got a Christchurch United player down the centre of the field. It's Alan Carville. I think there was an incident there, Ricky. I didn't see anything. It's possibly maybe a little bit of cramp. I don't know, Carville.
Yes, he's just gone down in the middle of the pitch there, John. He may just have taken a knock in the penalty area scramble before, but he seems in a little bit of pain. But knowing Alan, he's sure to bounce back up. He's got that hat trick dangling in front of him.
Certainly has. Scored two goals already. Of course, he's got 14 goals in the league this year, making him his club's leading goal scorer. He's quickly back on his feet. Carville gets a touch. Good clear by Jennison.
Eddie Gavigan looking a bit puzzled there, John. One of the nice guys in New Zealand soccer.
Knee foul. It's a good clearance by Dean Smith into space. He's forced Alan Stroud way out of his goal. I mean, both players have got their eye on the ball. They don't know where each other is. Often collisions. Normally, the referee rules in favour of the defensive team. Got support from Redemption outside. Comes inside to Barkley. It's Gavigan looking for the turn. Plays Barkley in on the left foot. Lightbound's on the back post. Here's Lightbound. Oh, and he's just flicked away by Kevin Calder. That's a far more composed build-up by Mark Wellington, Ricky.
That's right, John. I think if they just slow the game down and play the way that they can play, you know, I'm sure the benefits will come. Both sides are still tending to adopt this nonsense stuff and get the ball forward early, but when they knock it round and play it simple, it looks good. Both sides.
Strong challenge by Carville. This central striker is just covering every blade of grass on this field today. scored both his team's goals. And he's back in defence. Very quickly, number nine. Carvel. Straight back in the action at the other end. Ball by Michael Boober. It's a goal kick. Kevin, Gavin going to claim a corner, but no.
Come on, Reid! Pick it up!
Just over 15 minutes remaining in this game. Threesa beat Christchurch 2, Bournemouth Wellington 2. And the Allied Incentive, of course, this year for the first time. Wingfield have provided prize money, so $5,000 will go to the winner. $2,000 to the runner-up. A little bit of argy-bargy going in here. Frustration continues between Alan Carvel and John Lay. It certainly looked as though Alan Carvel was the instigator on that occasion. Good fatherly words again by the referee Roger Boomer.
I think it highlights, John, just the pressure this game does have. It is a big cup final, and players are looking for that winning medal.
Well, throughout New Zealand football, I mean, the character of the football, as I said earlier, is about Mount Wellington and Christchurch United. This tremendous competitive approach between the two clubs throughout the 20 years of the National League, and that's certainly showing here today. Mount Wellington have been unbeaten against this side for probably about the last 4 or 5 years. Church's record could be improved here with a very good shot by Julian Palou and a very, very good save again by Grant Schofield. Still action aplenty here at the basin. Once again, Palou. Ronnie Armstrong caught in 2 minds. Fortunately, and here is Falou's shot. Brilliant left-handed save, low to his left from Grant Schofield. That ball just might have been inching in to the far corner of the net, Ricky.
Here's the thing, once again, another great save from Grant. He's had a good season for the Mount, and once again, he's come to their rescue there. Good run from Julian Falou down this left-hand flank.
There is Schofield. Had a lot of work to do, but certainly no more than his opposite number, Alan Stroud, and both of them have played quite superbly today. Slight bound. Looking to bend the ball in, but that ball goes harmlessly over the post. So a goal kick to Threesa beat Christchurch. And we're going to see substitution very shortly, I'm sure. Kelvin Sefton.
Stop. Stop. Right. On a killer. Get out.
Kelvin Sefton is going on, and it must be an injury. It's a strange mood if it's not, because Morning Jennison is coming off the field.
He's talking in there, eh?
Kelvin Sefton will go and play alongside Ronnie Armstrong in look to be injured, Jennison.
No, he's come off the field. He looks, he's run off the pitch, John, so he looks as if he's capable of playing on, but never know, he may just have a slight hamstring pull or a groin or something, but yes, a very strange substitution.
Maybe the pace of Carvel is beginning to worry David Taylor in these last 15 minutes.
Well, Alan has come right back into the game, and he has scored the two vital goals, and that could be a factor, John.
There is Morley Jennison on the bench now.
Push up,
Dino! Chinese manager, David Taylor.
Kelvin Sefton, John, as we know, he did score the winner down in Christchurch in the vital league match, so perhaps that's put something in his favour.
Taylor might have heard you there, Ricky, because he had a little bit of a wry smile there, and whether he's looking for history to repeat itself or not, I don't know, but certainly Sefton did score the winner in Christchurch a week ago in the league match. Kelvin Sefton's father's here today, Alan Sefton. Famous footballer and more famous now for his yachting exploits. Currently working with Michael Fay in the America's Cup Challenge. It'll take place in San Diego next year. Donahue to Winnebeen, and Winnebeen really gets hold of that one, but it's over the top of the bar. It causes no concern at all for goalkeeper Alan Stroud. Winnebeen's free kick.
Here we are, John. Yes, having played with Dave over a number of years, he is a terrific striker of the ball, and I've seen many of those fill the back of the net.
Started
to come into the game the longer it's gone on, and that this could be a telling factor.
Gary Whips in another cross. Blue wins the header. Mr. Halligan. Striving for that third elusive goal. This is O'Donoghue. To Barkley.
Selfish here and had to go himself, but he laid it off, and unfortunate for Keith Brathwaite, has gone back for a corner.
Here comes the corner. Once again, that'll be another corner. And it's a difficult game now for both sides, because Michael Redenter was supporting Noel Barkley in the last attack, and suddenly when they lost the ball, the break to McGarry, and there was nobody to mark him, and they're just going to have to be cautious while still trying to get the winning goal. It's going to be a difficult job now for both sides. It's Christchurch at the moment. Denton hammers that ball clear, only as far as McGarry. As McGarry whips another ball across. Oh, there's a good header by Burway. Almost caught Schofield napping.
I think Yo Burway would have been one of the lightest persons in the ground if that one had gone on the back of the net.
Certainly would have been very pleased, because it was the own goal, as you said earlier. Full marks to Schofield, but the danger is the quality of the crosses now that McGarry's whipping across is really causing havoc in the Mount Wellington defence. Schofield's really forced back very quickly on that occasion. Knight's light brown trying to find some space for himself. He's won the corner. So within seconds they're down the other end, and it's a corner to Mount Wellington. Chance for Michael Redemption. Keeper's still on the ground. United will let off the hook now. McGarry breaks again. Going to get past Dean Smith. He does so. He's got Braithwaite in the middle. Oh, my. So close for McGarry.
John needs a tremendous job there. A powerful run from Michael Mulgarry down the flank. Just slips past Dean Smith. Cuts inside the covering defender here, Ronnie Armstrong. The advancing Grant Schofield coming out, and Johnny Lay perhaps was on the cover there, but all credit to Michael and all credit to Grant.
Halligan with the corner. I think Three's Heavy Christchurch looking the more composed side at the moment. Certainly this game could still go either way.
I think the key figure, John, as you said before, is Michael Mulgarry. He's really come into the game in this last 20 minutes, and he's unless Mount get a grip of him, he could be a danger.
Space. Falloon. Oh, and a good early shot by Falloon. Just couldn't control it. Got underneath it. Certainly around the Mount Wellington penalty area, there seems to be all sorts of problems at the moment.
Dino.
Just over the bar, Ricky.
Here's another good run from Julian Falloon. Tense moments now, John. We're going into the back end of the match, and although both sides will be striving for that winning goal, you've got to be very, very cautious of what you're doing in the back third.
Well, the experts on the bench know what needs to be done, but it's difficult to portray that on the field. Just under 10 minutes left in this second half now. Titanic struggle, both teams locked at two goals apiece, striving for the winner. I'm sure neither of these teams want to go into extra time. Lovely turn again by Barclay. This time O'Donoghue gets in the way. As expected now, and so much hard work gone in by all these 22 players on the field. One or two passes starting to go astray. He's had an excellent game. People start to be thinking about the man of the match now. Got a number of contenders. I think Carmel's played well, and Mulgarry in particular for Christchurch, Ricky.
Yes, I've been very impressed with young Lawrence Fitzpatrick at right back too, John. I think he's also a very young player, and he's had a very, very steady game.
Barclay, of course, from Mount Wellington. Played superbly. Redemption, John Lay. Very good individual performances, as well as two excellent team performances today.
I think both goalkeepers as well, John, they've certainly earned their money today.
Yes, indeed. Yeah, both keepers played extremely well. Denton had to hurry for that one. He's overhit the ball. Control the pass. To Grant
Lightbound. Leave it.
Early. Lock it.
Let me go
with it. Ball bounces kindly for Winnerveen. Then forces Calder to give away a corner kick. The determination there by David Winnerveen. Always look dangerous, Mark Wellington, on these set plays, but as yet, have not had any success.
Keep up! Yes, Mike!
Now just forced Palm the ball out. Push them out! This is Redempton.
Get a corner! Push out!
Palmer turns the ball in. Have it clear by Michael Boomer.
Thank you.
switch to the near side. Michael Redempton now in a more familiar position on this right-hand side of the field. Keith Braithwaite playing his fifth final for Christchurch United. Looking Carvel, Falloon looking for a penalty. A little bit hopeful on that occasion. I think there's nothing amiss there, Ricky.
I think so, John. I think coming into the last couple of minutes, they'll all be looking for whatever pieces they can pick up.
They settle for anything at this stage of the game, won't they?
Oh, I think so.
There is the scoreline. Christchurch 2, Mount Wellington 2. In the last couple of minutes of play. He tries to turn.
Go white! Get him in! Turn on! Meet it back!
Right back with the cross. Well, Winterbean has it. He might be a believing. Oh, Winterbean had a glorious chance. The sort of chance that he normally thrives on. The ball dropped kindly for him on the first occasion. It was a beautiful touch over the top of Burway. And he just got underneath the volley.
Oh, Dave will be disappointed there, John. If you ever wanted a person to finish a goal and with a couple of minutes left in that position, Dave would have been the man. And he's unfortunately popped one over the top. We're starting to see a few tired legs out there now, John.
Well, I think it's going to be a pity that this game is not going to be won in normal time. We must be just moving into injury time now. Mark Wellington looked to come forward, but McGarry challenges back, and Lightman fouls McGarry. Quickly taken by McGarry into Braithwaite. That's the second foul on McGarry in a short space of time, and Michael Redempton will get a yellow card. For the referee now, because as you said, Ricky, the players are getting tired. Just a little bit slow getting to players. They stick a leg out, hoping to get the ball.
Yeah, it's been able to maintain their confidence, John, and the ability to strike right through for the full 90 minutes.
Well, Wellington really defending here with the sun in their eyes now as Calder drives this ball in. Cleared away by Dave Winterbean. It's a lone figure of Eddie Gavigan up front at the moment. The wings are throwing. We're going to see a last-minute winner. Gavigan flicks it across. This is Barclay looking for support. Back heel, but Dean Smith can't get to that ball, but it's hammered into touch by Julian Falloon. So they'll be looking for one last long throw from Grant Lightbound. To Barclay's feet. Smith challenges to his cross challenge down. Barclay's so quick again onto that ball. Winterbean out to Lightbound, looking for the opening cross from Lightbound. There's Barclay. Halligan clears. That's a foul by David Winterbean.
Well, this is going to be very interesting. Do you want to see what the outcome is here?
Well, he's going to be sent off, isn't he?
Something's
going to
happen. We'll see.
Yeah, it's a tragedy. There's time upon the clock. They would have been got booked in the first half. And he
it's his second booking offence. He was just frustrated. He couldn't turn quickly enough. He was held on. And then Carville got goal side of him and pushed him away. And rightly or wrongly, but Mr. Woolmer is in charge. So tragedy for Mark Wellington. 10 men on the field of play now and looking as if they're going to face extra time.
No, they have to go out.
That's disappointing, John. It's been a very, very good game, and that's a sad point to perhaps end on.
Well, it always amazes me. I mean, it's been a superb game of football. It's not been a nasty game. I'm not criticising Roger Woolmer's decision. He's left with very little choice if it's a second booking offence, but it always seems a pity. When the player, you know, the game has been played in tremendous spirit, very competitive, very hard, but usually very fair. Sefton. A good break here by Fitzpatrick, and he's got 6 players in the penalty area. Crosses a poor one. Run away by Dean Smith. But they'll be hard pressed now, Mark Wellington. Losing that man in midfield. Slight foul.
It's amazing though, John, how many times we see it. 10 men and they can bounce back.
Has brought this game to a close, so we're going to have to face extra time.
Shades of 1972 when these two teams last met. It actually took 3 times for a result.
So there it is, the scores are locked at 2-2. Carville has equalised in the second half of Christchurch United, and is now going to be 15 minutes of extra time with all the players on very tired legs indeed.
The players just change in, so we've got extra time at 2-all in the 1990s Chatham Cup final.
Both players, sets of teams, getting the players together. So we'll be back here at the Basin Reserve for another 15 minutes each way after the break.
For the first of 2 periods of...
Well, real drama here at the Basin Reserve and a rather windy Wellington this afternoon. This is real cup final stuff. 2-all, 2 15-minute periods of extra time. There must be a winner here this afternoon, unlike the 4-all draw way back in 1972 between these two sides. Going into this extra time, of course, Christchurch United, I suppose, must start favourite as the Mount has lost a key midfield man, Dave Witteveen, sent off with just minutes remaining in that second half. So when we come back, the players are off the field for 5 minutes, and there'll be some very weary legs out there too. When we come back, 15 minutes each way, and if it's still locked, say at 2-all or 3-all by that stage, we then go into a penalty shootout situation. So there must be a winner down here at the Basin Reserve this afternoon. Back shortly on the field, Mount Wellington and Christchurch United. And remember, the Mount with just 10 players. So while we wait for the players to come back on the field, we can recap on the highlights this afternoon. Of course, Christchurch took the early lead through Alan Carville in the 10th minute. Then tragedy for Christchurch, an own goal. Johan Verwey putting the ball over his own goalkeeper. And then the Mount came back, grabbed the lead, 2-1, a brilliant goal by Noel Barclay. But then Alan Carville, early in the second half, bringing Christchurch back into the game at 2-all. In the last 30 minutes, goalless, but not without incident. It's real cup final stuff out there. And we're getting close to the players coming back on the field. What should be a very absorbing and testing final 30 minutes of this cup final here at the Basin Reserve in Wellington. Remember, if there are no goals in this extra time, we go into a penalty shootout. John Adsett and Ricky Herbert for their thoughts as we count down to this crucial last 30 minutes of play.
Thank you, Stephen. Yes, indeed. Really a test of character now for Mount Wellington. Tragically down to 10 men for that sending off of Dave Witteveen. And really, Ricky, that's going to really pose problems for them.
I think so, John, but, you know, one would think that the favour's going to go with Christchurch, but we've seen it time and time again. The ability of 10 men to bounce back, and I think Mount Wellington do have that character in the side. I think, from my point of view, the next goal is going to be the winner.
Well, certainly these two teams true to form the last time they met, 1972. At that day, the venue was the same here at the Basin Reserve, and the teams drew by 4 goals each, drew a second replay. So, nothing seems to have changed over 18 years. And certainly in Ronnie Armstrong's case, the players haven't changed either. So Mount Wellington get this first period of extra time underway. Slight change of formation. Dean Smith now creating at left full-back. Michael Redenton has moved across with Michael McGarry. Push on Noel Barclay. I assume Winnerveen have those two free kicks that he failed with in the second half, and of course he's not here now, so the attacking free kicks have got to be readjusted as well.
Yes, I think we'll probably see a strike here from Grant Lightbrown.
There is Lightbrown's try, that was dipping. Reaction was, Ricky, that was going to go well over the bar.
It was. The last sort of 10 metres, John, here we see it. The last, I think it may have had a wee deflection. Alan Stroud did very well to readjust and to tip over for a corner.
There's the resulting corner kick take by Eddie Gadigan. Redemption's a good strong header. This is where Christchurch United can be so dangerous. They break very quickly indeed, they get players forward. Alan Carville.
John Lay there, John, just back covering in defence for the Mount side. He's got through a power of work this afternoon.
So it'll be a goal kick to Christchurch United. And maybe one or two people in this crowd that misread the game today and booked a flight back to Auckland at 4:40. Their New Zealand Dow will be very disappointed indeed. Well, the Auckland National Director of Coaching, Alan Jones, was due to go out on that plane, and whether he'll take the chance to stay, Ricky, I don't know now.
Oh, I'm sure Alan will be disappointed.
Fitzpatrick with the free kick. A needless corner there for Christchurch. Rather fancied Greg Schofield coming to meet that ball. Ricky seemed he had plenty of time, left it to the defenders.
Yes, he stayed on his line, and unfortunately I think Ronnie Armstrong was expecting him to come out and put Ronnie in two minds. Unfortunately, they've conceded a corner.
Bring everybody back now, the Mount, playing with only 10 men. There's a good head down, and lovely save by Schofield, and again it was Burway. But got that header in. When he goes forward, he's a very good player in the air, Ricky, isn't he still?
Oh, he's very strong, John. Here we see him, he leaps very well. Unfortunately, he's unable to chip Grant.
John, no, no,
there is your Burway, as I was saying earlier in the commentary. He used to be a central striker. So he's well used to putting these chances away. He stands about 6'3", so it does give him a basic advantage in the air. McGarry really hammers that ball across the face. He's won himself another corner. Those viewers not really adversant with the sport. To play a ball with that pace and that accuracy is tremendous technique that this man shows.
There you go.
Give it down.
Drifted onto the back post, looking again for Burway. Schofield is there to spoil the chance. So a busy time for Grant Schofield, and possibly may get busier, Ricky.
Yes, I think so, John. I think both ends, obviously both sides are striving for this winning goal, and we're going to see some very interesting happenings in and around that area.
didn't he?
That's the thick off of Gavigan, and there's Barkley. Oh, Calder covered very, very quickly indeed there. Barkley showed a little lovely flick from Gavigan, and Barkley then showed tremendous technique to keep in possession of that ball, but Calder came round the back of him on the blind side very quickly indeed. Taken off or came off injured, we don't know which, Ricky, but you know, this, you feel these two such experienced players there that you can't do without.
No, this is a very vital time, John. It's extra time, and that's where you need the Ronnie Armstrongs, the Dave Woodavines, the Martin Jennisons. But Mount, I'm sure they can battle through it. They've still got some players out there in the Michael Roy Dentons, and Ronnie's still out playing very well, and John Lay's had a superb game in the middle of the park, and they're going to have to rely on these players to get the younger ones, the Dean Smiths and the Kelvin Sefton, through.
To play gone in this first period of extra time here at the Basin Reserve, and these two teams still locked at 2-2. Free kick to 3-0 Christchurch, taken by Fitzpatrick. Lovely little flick by Braithwaite. The Dean Smith forced to hook that ball clear. Another corner. I think this is corner number 5 for Christchurch in his first period of extra time. It just emphasises the pressure they're applying onto this Mount Wellington goal. Way again, wins the header, is Braithwaite. Oh, the goalkeeper's come. Oh, he's been so fortunate to get it. Entertainment plus there, because it looked like Braithwaite was just going to flick it over his head.
Well, he'd done the initial bit very well, Keith Braithwaite, and then it appeared that Grant had missed the ball, but he managed to dive through and smother it. It was a good effort by Grant. Here we see it here. Keith chests it down. Looks as if he's just going to chip it, takes it down again. He's lost Grant, but he managed to swoop back and make the vital save. We see a rather sigh of relief there, John, on Grant's face.
Well, he's made some unbelievable saves today. This is Gavigan. Right, I'm trying to get in, but the ball just overhit. I think key players for the Mount now are going to be, we're going to have to see improved performances over these extra time periods from both Stephen Donoghue and Eddie Gavigan. I think these two players are going to have to come into the game more and more. A second substitute, and actually Gavigan now is being replaced. He struggled a little bit in the back end of the second half, and David Taylor has decided to risk Terry Torrens, who's normally a regular member of this side, but has been down with the flu earlier this week and was put out of the side when Johnny Lay was preferred to start the game. Braithwaite looking to get McGarry clear, but that was nice to turn up by Sefton, who also seems to be limping.
Yes, I was watching him about 5 minutes ago, Johnny. He's certainly favouring one of those feet.
Sefton certainly looks to have a problem around the right ankle area. He's certainly carrying that leg, and I think David Taylor may have brought him on for his extra pace to play against Carvel. That's certainly going to nullify it. So really, everything against Mount Wellington at this moment of time. Down to 10 men. Use the second substitution. Central defender Kelvin Sefton is limping. Things couldn't be worse for them. Still, they come forward. Michael Redenton.
I think as we've seen over the season, John, this is probably where they're most vulnerable. They can, they're just likely to bounce back and sting you with a goal.
Very shifty, you can see him carrying that, that foot. McGarry caught offside. And the referee ruled in favour of Michael appealing, but he won't change his mind, Michael. Free kick to Bull Matt Wellington. Johnny Lay giving the ball in to Barclay, and a back header.
Out! Out! Are we done?
Halligan was just tripped. Well, I think, you know, what we're seeing at the moment, Ricky, Matt Wellington might do well to take this this game through to penalties. What do you think?
I think so. There's possibly one avenue that may be best explored for them, although they have just, in the last few minutes, got themselves back, and they've had a couple of half chances, but as you say, everything is stacked against them, but they do have that ability to counteract that.
He's got McGarry wide, but it's a poor pass. McGarry won't keep that one in now. Goal kick to Mount Wellington. It sets high standards, Michael McGarry, and quite rightly so. And he'd be disappointed with that pass because he made a beautiful run outside the fullback. The Boomer had a lot of space to play the ball into.
Feel sorry there, John, but once again, if a player's prepared to get the ball down and run at players in these type of instances, you never know what can happen. Well, the pressure certainly on Keith Braithwaite here. He'll be he's probably a good man to for the job.
Well, he's the expert penalty taker for VZB Christchurch. Yeah! He was on top of the ball before he struck it, Ricky.
Yes, it looked a very casual approach, John, and here we see him with his head in his hands, but Keith will be very disappointed. That could have sewn the match.
Well, there is Braithwaite. Put it in. Schofield went the right way, following the line of the ball. But the opportunity is missed and the mouth flowed back, but there'll be no danger there to Alan Stroud.
Keep working!
Keep working, says Evan Teal. And I've said it many times myself from the bench, and it's a pretty easy thing to say from the bench. Michael McGarry, brilliant run from him. Certainly Kelvin Sefton, he's really carrying that right leg more and more. But he'll certainly be a relieved young man at this moment of time. John play, strong as ever, superb, he's still in possession, he's a little bit angry, and he wasn't allowed to play on, but the foul was committed. But he's epitomised, really, this Mount Wellington approach today. There's certainly no guarantee he's going to get into the side. And there is the end of the first period of extra time. We're still locked at two goals each following the Braithwaite penalty miss. And we'll be back with you at the Basin Reserve after the break. And we're underway in the second period of extra time. In a game that has been an extraordinary game here at the Basin Reserve. One of the best Chatham Cup finals seen for many, many years. Two superbly contested teams in Christchurch United and Mount Wellington. And they're still locked at 2-2. Saddest man on the field to play at the moment, it will obviously be, I think, Ricky Keith Braithwaite.
Yes, he'll be feeling disappointed, John, but we've had good goals, we've had own goals, we've had missed penalties, and we've got 15 minutes of good football still to come yet, so let's hope that all the players have put that one missed behind them, and we see another entertaining 15.
Well, full marks to Paul Mount Wellington. They've had to battle this first 15 minutes of extra time with only 10 men. It does make life difficult, particularly at this stage of the game when the legs are very, very tired. It'll be a corner. Please, F.E. Christchurch. Distributors of the ball in the country. Rifles that ball onto the back post, looking for Carvel. Carvel's adjudged to a foul. And there's another Mount player down and out, and it looks like Grant Lightbound. I don't think there's much more can happen to this Wellington side at the moment, Ricky. I mean, it's been tragedy after tragedy for them.
Yes, unfortunately, John, everything seemed to have gone against them. They've had injured players, they've had players sent off, and but they're still in there. It's still 2-2, and they have that opportunity of still taking this this cup final.
I remember a couple of hours ago, they started the day having to make a very late replacement, and Andy Brown failed the fitness test. This young man, Dean Smith, came into the side. I'm sure he's certainly not let the side down at all. Battled well all day, young Dean Smith. There's a little bit of space now for Michael Redenton. Moving into the attacking mode. Can't get past Calder. Now there's oceans of space for Braithwaite. Alpha Falloon. One strong across quickly and bugging off the ball. Patrick. In again to Carvel.
Well done, Ronnie. Michael.
Ronnie Armstrong's challenge. Still, if anybody's got a right to feel tired at this moment of time, it's this man, Ronnie Armstrong. 30-something is the name of the show, and 30-something is what you get for his age. But we know he's been in league football for some 22 years, a magnificent record. There is Ronnie. He'll want this medal today as much as he wanted his first one. Some 18 years ago. There's another booking going in now. Christchurch United pick up their first booking. It's Michael Fullen. Like I say, a lot of it's tired just now, Ricky. This time challenges. Technique begins to go when the body gets tired.
I think so, John. You know, the odd legs just getting stuck out and just catching players, and unfortunately they're getting booked for it.
Walter looking for support. They head up for McGarry, a lovely turn by Braithwaite, and McGarry's free on the left arm. Oh, Michael Redenton, absolutely superb defending. by Radetzky, but he lost his balance and gave the ball away. And now it's Carvel onside, a great chance for Carvel. And that's a different, again, I don't know. Seemed a harsh decision, Ricky.
I think so, John. The goalkeeper's got to be entitled to come out and challenge for the ball. He's come out there, he's 50-50 challenge there with Alan Carvel, and once again it's gone against him. I think he's even made contact,
and Alan's fallen.
Alan's fallen over his leg.
Yeah. So, anyway, a free kick going in favour here of Christchurch United. Very dangerous position, particularly Michael McGarry standing over the ball. The man will feel harshly judged as this ball hits the back of the net. It's cannoned off for Denton.
Hold it, hold it, hold it!
Going on the near side, Redenton's still holding that leg where the ball struck him. Very painful when it hits the inside of the thigh. Well, we're now 10 minutes away from a penalty shootout as Christchurch United plus.
No!
Foul throw by Falloon. Both feet, possibly behind the field of play, and the throw's taken. There is Martin Stewart, Christchurch United manager, looking hopeful. This side has the advantage at the moment, not by the scoreline, just by the number of players on the field. There is the Matt Wellington bench. David Taylor now on his feet. Difficult job now for the Mount. They've got to come back and defend, and it's very difficult to get players forward.
I think Christchurch will be looking for this winner, John, because if it goes to penalties, there's certainly no advantage there. And with them got the extra man now, they've got to press forward.
Well, that's right. If Mark Wellington can hold out for the next 8 minutes, then everything becomes equal. And there's now, that's a very rare decision. Steps by the goalkeeper. A goalkeeper in today's modern football cannot take more than 4 steps whilst holding the ball. And on that occasion, Alan Stroud took about 6. And in a lot of circumstances, as long as you're trying to keep the play going, referees are allowed to go.
Yes, it's one of those fine lines, John. And unfortunately for Alan, he's been penalised there. And this just could be the answer that Matt Wellington's looking for. The players with ability is Noel Barkley and Steve O'Donoghue, Terry Torrens. This could be very dangerous.
Well, obviously, he's been judged as trying to gain an advantage by an illegal manner. This could be flicked to Terry Torrens. He's got a very powerful left foot. Torrens. Oh, and he saved it! Yeah. It's there! It's there! Matt Wellington has scored! And I think it is Ronnie Armstrong. This is over. It is unbelievable. Because with 7 minutes to go, Terry Torrens, the substitute, hammered in the free kick. The ball broke free, and there was Ronnie Armstrong, 22 years in the league, the veteran of the game, played in the cup final in 1972 against this club, the last time they met, and there it is, Ricky, it couldn't have gone to a nicer man.
Oh, Ronnie will absolutely thrilled, and I take my hat off. There's Dave. We've got a shot of Dave Taylor there. He'll be absolutely ecstatic. I do feel happy. I've had 8 seasons at that club, absolutely delighted for Dave and Noel. Ronnie there, getting embraced on the ground. He'll be absolutely delighted. Well done, Ronnie.
Well, this game has had absolutely everything. It did cross my mind a few minutes ago to say all it needs now is Ronnie Armstrong to get a goal, but with 10 men and playing in a defensive position, one couldn't have thought it possible, but that's the way this game has been, and certainly Christchurch are not done yet. And there's a free kick there for handball by Kelvin Sefton. So now Christchurch have around 6 or 7 minutes to pull this game round again. And I'm sure at McKinley Park, the wives, the girlfriends, the supporters that couldn't get here today will be going absolutely crazy. Here's McGarry. State there by Falloon. Let's Matt Wellington off the hook. I don't know whether you've seen any of the Matt Wellington across the halfway line now, Ricky.
Well, I think they're going to keep numbers back and probably defend for this last 5 or 6 minutes. There we have Ronnie Armstrong. Look, he's an absolute credit to the game.
Well, he's a role model for any young player. I worked at the Mount for 2 years. In the first year I was there, I asked him if he wanted to go into coaching because anyone fancy his legs to keep him playing. That was 2 years ago. And he's here today, 2 years later, scoring possibly the winning goal in a Chatham Cup final. Terry Torrance, sensible play, just running the ball into space, trying to take up as much of the time now as possible. Less than 5 minutes remaining now in this epic encounter. It's a throw in to Christchurch United. The crowd is alive, I think all the neutral supporters here for Wellington are just enthralled with this game that he's been here today. Here's Fitzpatrick. Michael McGarry. And again, good defensive play. Michael McGarry's really handled his redemption's played so well against McGarry.
I think Michael's had a top season, John. He's a very, very mature player nowadays, and I'd have to agree, he's marked Michael very well. He's had a good campaign with the All Whites, and he's had a very strong game here this afternoon. We've got Noel Barkley dropping back into the back four, John. I think this is going to be a good 5 minutes. They're going to have to hold on now.
Yeah, it's certainly now they've pushed away in front. It's got to be a backs to the wall. Backs to the wall performance now by the Mount. Furway, centre half, allowed to come forward. Balloon looking to get the cross in. Really tricks Dean Smith. There's the cross. There's McGarry! There's McGarry's header, wide of the outstretched arms.
Has had everything and there's more to come.
Brilliant goal, Ricky.
Oh, I'm absolutely lost for words, John. I don't know what to say. Tremendous stuff. Julian Falloon's turned on the flank there. Great ball in, and who else but to put the ball away? Players' Player of the Year, Michael McGarry. Tremendous stuff. This is going to go to penalties, I'm sure of it. It'll have to.
Absolutely electric at this moment of time. Martin Stewart down and out 1 minute, back in the game the next. Mark Wellington dead and buried early in this extra time, came back from the dead, and now the same has been done by 3ZB Christchurch. Off cross here, forced away by Kelvin Sefton for a corner kick. The hands are clinging to the heads on the bench. There's the physio, Bryce Hastings. Absolutely incredible game to see here today. Danny Halligan to take the corner kick. Oh, with a bit of panic for Schofield. He punched when he could have caught that ball.
Stuart Stone.
Well, what an advertisement for football we've seen here this afternoon, John. If this can't get people out to support the Coda, I'm not quite sure what'll do it.
Well, I think everybody here and everybody watching at home, Ricky, will have to agree. It's shown everything that's good about the game. It's disappointments, it's joys. There is the end of the game. We're going to penalties, and we'll be back with a penalty shootout immediately after this commercial break.
Well, folks, the 1990 Chatham Cup has not yet been decided. The last time these two teams met was in 1972, and they had a hell of a ding-dong battle.
Well, we're ready for the penalty shootout, of course, to decide this match. It looked as though the Mount had wrapped it up in extra time. The man we're seeing on camera, Ronnie Armstrong, it looked as though he put the Mount in front. The penalty saved by the goalkeeper, but it pops out, and Armstrong, Johnny on the spot, 38 years young, Ronnie Armstrong. Delight from Mount Wellington. At that stage, the Mount up 3-2. Looked theirs, but it wasn't to be. Christchurch Storm back onto attack. Brilliant header by Michael McGarry, the player's player of the year. 3-3, hence the penalty shootout. What a cup final. So the penalty shootout, real drama here. Sudden death. You miss, you're in trouble. The players have had 4 or 5 minutes to try and compose themselves. The coaches have been out in the middle of the field. And obviously they've had to sort out order. Who's first up? Who's going to take that first shot? Real pressure situation here. Both goalkeepers have been in sensational form today, especially Grant Schofield in the Mount Wellington goal. Several match-winning saves by him. Real pressure as we go back to our commentators, John Adshead and Ricky Herbert.
Thank you very much indeed, Stephen, and pressure it is. And it's always unfortunate, Ricky, to see a match as good as this decided by this type of situation where a penalty shootout. I suppose one of the most anxious people down there now will be Keith Braithwaite.
Yes, I think so, John. It'll be interesting to see if Keith does take a penalty this time round. I'm sure he will. He's played in the big arena before, and I'm sure he'll bounce back and take one. But it's a very difficult position to be in. If you miss, you know, you can risk putting your side out.
Well, the situation in a penalty shootout is that each team will take 5 penalties. Different players obviously will take those penalties, and at the end of those 5 penalties, if it is undecided and it's level at 5 each, then the other players in the team will go on a sudden death situation. So the first 5 penalties will be taken by each side, unless of course there is a winning margin before the 5 penalties have been taken. So it's a lot of pressure on the players at this stage, particularly, you know, it's been a long game, they've had extra time, and I don't think anybody relishes this situation.
As you say, John, it's very unfortunate that a game of this quality has to end. Perhaps a replay may have been a better alternative, but we're here, we've got penalties. Players have got to get themselves composed. They've played 90 minutes of full time, then they've gone into 15 minutes each way again for extra time, and now they've got to get their minds on the right note to take this crucial penalty kick.
Well, the first player up, obviously they've tossed up, and Mount Wellington will go first. This can be an advantage, of course, but it's important that you get this first penalty into the back of the net. And it'll be Terry Torrens, came on as substitute. For the Maori, he's been sick during the week and lost his place in the side to John Lay. And he's got the enormous task now of coming on. Remember, it was free kick taken by Terry Torrens that gave Mount Wellington the chance. And he scored it just correct under the crossbar. So delighted Terry Torrens jogs back to the middle. And it's the irrepressible Michael McGarry. No chances being taken. It's like a chess game now, because you select players that have got the character, got the nerve to keep you in the game. So Michael McGarry's kick now, if he can convert it, will replace the pressure back onto Mount Wellington. Oh, and Schofield is saved. Schofield has made a brilliant save, low to his left. McGarry was asking the referee the question that he moved, but the flag stayed down. There is a two-man decision here for penalties. The referee is by the spot kick, and there is a linesman, Mr. Gary Fleet, watching the goalkeeper There it goes, and the feet really didn't move until the kick was taken. So brilliant save by Grant Schofield. So there's the first break for Mount Wellington. Noel Barkley. And he's beaten Alan Stroud. So the pressure really now is on this man going forward, Keith Braithwaite. He had the chance to give Christchurch United the lead in normal time, but he missed the penalty on that occasion. But he's very experienced, very mature player, very professional player. Oh, Braithwaite went for goal! And he's going to get a second opportunity. Referee Roger Rulber has ruled that he moved on that occasion. That virtually would have given Mount Wellington the game. Very disappointed is Grant Schofield. And McGarry, and it was Braithwaite, he went for the opposite corner than he did in the penalty miss. Oh, and this time he's just found the corner. Ronnie Stewart applauds. So it's 2-1 now to Mount Wellington. And it's the veteran, the supreme, Ronnie Armstrong, comes forward to keep his side in the lead. Taken three penalties to Christchurch's two. They lead 2-1. Burway now can level the scores. Opportunity. You could cut the tension with a knife here at the Basin Reserve. Yes, disappointment there for Schofield. Now, Barkley in the middle, disappointed. And he saved this one, and it is. He's up. He's got to want to stay up here. I thought he was going to get a fall.
One must say, John, probably justice for Grant Schofield.
Well, I mean, even if you move to save a penalty, it's brilliant. But I mean, Schofield is just absolutely playing out of his tree in this situation. So, Mount Wellington now, once again, have the lead by 2-1. Yeah! Lightbound gives them three. And this game that's been tension from the 10th minute when Alan Carvel opened the scoring.
Come on, Stuart, listen, he's all the way, son.
You can hear the comment that was made by Grant Lightbound. Schofield saves this, Mount Wellington have won, so tremendous pressure on young Michael Boomer. Michael Boomer must score here to keep Christchurch United in this game. One or two of the Mount players are turning away, they're not even having a look. Boomer's done it! So it's left now for Steve O'Donoghue. If Donoghue converts this penalty, Mark Wellington will finally win this Chatham Cup final. If he misses, then there's a chance still for Christchurch. So here we are. Stephen O'Donoghue joined the club this year from Wellington. Strand happy where the ball is. So the tension remains till the end. It's now 25-5. The game started at 2 o'clock this afternoon. This is it. And Wellington have won! Both Wellington champions! Champions of the Chatham Cup! Chance of the Regan Cup double! They go crazy, there's been tension throughout and full marks to the mount.
I think they've had to battle right through with all the unlucky instances today, John, and all credit to them. Here we are, Dole Park, all the lads know them very well and are absolutely delighted for them.
Well, what can you say? We've been privileged today at the Basin Reserve to witness one of the most exciting football matches for many, many years. The game started with Alan Carvel scoring for Christchurch. You were his own goal. Have a goal down to join in the celebrations on the pitch. So there we are. Carvel opened the scoring after 10 minutes. Back into the game. Barkley gave Mount Wellington the lead. Carvel equalised, and then we went into extra time when Ronnie Armstrong, the veteran, put Mount Wellington back in the lead. McGarry equalised with just a couple of minutes to go, and it was all left to a penalty shootout. And there was the winning goal scored by Steve O'Donoghue. We've had a magnificent day, Ricky. There are the Mount players. You must be delighted for them as well.
Oh, absolutely, John. One person I'm absolutely delighted for is Dave Taylor. We're very good friends, and with Dave having his first season, absolutely delighted. I hope they go on and do the double now. I'm sure they're very, very capable, and I'm sure they'll definitely do it.
Let's remember as well, it takes two teams to make a game such as this, and one cannot pass without paying credit to the 3ZB Christchurch side. A magnificent performance by them. There is Ronnie Armstrong signing the autographs. So Mount Wellington pick up the Winfield $5,000 check. It's been a great game. Down to the ground, and from us to Ricky Herbert and myself, it's goodbye from the Basin Reserve.